All right, so in this video, I'm going to show what I think are the best ways to farm materials. And these should get you everything you need if you're just running normal missions. But if you're grinding MSK a lot, like practicing solo and doing a bunch of carries, then you're going to need to find a way to get like extra batteries and coal and flower petals. Like, I don't think any amount of grinding is going to get you what you need if you're doing that a bunch. The first and the easiest thing that I like to do is expeditions. And there are two types of expeditions that I like to do. One of them is for crafting materials, which is that red toolbox. And the other is traps. So I sent out a few expeditions yesterday, and they all came back. And so I'll show what you get. So let's just claim these. All right, so this was a trap. 10 of those. There's another trap one. And it doesn't really matter the power level of these, because what we're interested in really is the nuts and bolts and the planks and the rough ore. So, and batteries, you know, hopefully if we get like ceiling electrics and stuff. Wow, it's just giving me a bunch of floor spikes. Oh, we got some dynamos. Alright, and this was the red toolbox one, so you get a bunch of stuff from those. Like, what we like to get are flower petals, blast powder, nuts and bolts, like 500 nuts and bolts here. Some coal, resin, you know, bacon batteries, rough ore. All that stuff's useful. All these other lower level things you can just junk. Alright, so if we go here, let me just junk some of those low-level things so you can see what you get from recycling all the traps. Transfer this out. Okay. Junk that. Alright, so these are all the traps that I got from the expeditions. And if we just recycle them, we'll see how much stuff we get from them. So now if you look, we get some batteries, like a ton of nuts and bolts, planks, rough ore. There's other low-level things we just junk, so this was not even a great return. Like, I just kept getting floor spikes. Sometimes you get ceiling electrics and gas traps and stuff like that, so you get a bunch of batteries from those, from the ceiling electrics. All right, so that was expeditions, and then the other thing that I like to do to get mats like wood, brick, and metal is just run endurance and have your recycle mat grinder running, and you'll get 150 of each mat every minute. So about, I think it's like every 30 minutes or something, you get a full stack of brick, metal, and wood. And so the loadout that I like to use is Mega Base Kyle in the lead, and this is so that your base extends further out, and your recycler can reach more tiles. Recycling team perk, obviously. Base Kyle, Power Base Nox, these don't really matter. Machinist Mina for your chapter ability. This Gadgeteer perk to decrease your gadget cooldowns, and then Survivalist Jonesy. And this is because of that shield bubble round in Endurance where you take damage. So having Survivalist Jonesy will just heal you back up so you don't die when you're AFK. And then I have this teleporter gadget, and that's so that I can teleport back from my mat grinder to my storage, like, really quickly. So to store my mats when My inventory is full. And then supply drop. And that's why we have Gadgeteer on here, so we can drop more supply drops. Alright, so I'm just going to load into an endurance and just show what I do. Let's just load into my Stonewood. Alright, so once you're in your home base, just fire up your endurance. And then go to your mat grinder and place down your base for recycling. And then what I like to do is you put your teleporter down and then just put the other end over by your storage here. And so now you can just sit here, and whenever you're full on like brick, metal, or wood, you just teleport over, drop it off in your storage, and then teleport back. And I just do this whenever I'm AFKing in Endurance, just for Battle Pass XP or perk up or whatever. That's what I do. I just have my recycler going. Grab it every 5 minutes or so. I think that's when it fills up to 1,000 of each, and then just teleport. You know, once I hit 5,000 of something, I just teleport back here, drop it off in the storage, and come back. And so it's a really easy way to get your mats. So see, like I was full on bricks, so I just teleport up here. Storage is full, and just transfer something out. Transfer my brick in, just go back. Yeah, that's all I do. It's real simple. And after one endurance, I mean, you get a ton of mats. Like, I don't know, a lot. You just get a lot. All right, so the last thing that I do is actually go out and farm stuff. And the loadout that I use is Archaeologess in the lead. And I know there's some debate whether she's the best, or Clip is the best, or Fossil Southie is the best in the lead. I definitely think Jess or Southie is the best in the lead. Like, I would only put Clip in the lead if I was specifically looking for something that's hard to find, like Coal or Bright Core or Sunbeam. Just because Jess and Southie, they can punch so many more times than Clip. Like, Clip, you're just sitting around waiting for energy all the time. And I prefer Archaeologess in the lead, just because with Southie in the lead, you have to put another Dino Hero on your loadout, which is kind of a waste of a slot. So that really tips it in favor, for me at least, of having Jess in the lead. And plus, also, I've 144'd my Archaeologess because that's the hero that you use on some of the Frost Knight variants. So, yeah, I have Jess in the lead. Blast from the Past team perk. Clip. I don't know these guys' names. The one that makes your phase shift, you run faster. The one that reduces your phase shift cooldown. And then Parasaur Jess, so that every time you phase shift around, you're healing. Because in some of the maps, you know, if you have a storm that's going around you, especially on like resupplies, well, when you're just phase shifting around, you're always healing. And then Fossil Southie to regenerate energy. And then gadgets I use, supply drop and adrenaline rush. And so what I do is, since I'm always wanting more nuts and bolts and batteries and efficient parts, I always go to this 140 map right here, because this is always going to be an industrial park zone. And it's a, you know, 140, so I'm going to be getting a lot of the 5-star materials. So I always pick this one, and I just run around punching all the cars and all the mechanical things just to get as many nuts and bolts and batteries as I can. So I'm just going to load in here quickly and show you what I do. Right, so once you're in, I mean, it's not rocket science. You just go around punching everything that you see, right? And I usually like to go for the mechanical things, because that's what I run low on. Mainly nuts and bolts and batteries. So I usually just try to go for the cars, these things. What else did I go for? If you find a building, this building right here, with a bunch of these like washer dryer machines, if you search them, they have a tendency to give batteries. So let me see if I can search this one without breaking it. So you get batteries from that. Efficient. Wow, usually they give batteries. Of course, now I say something. They're all looted, jeez. Well, anyways, you can still just punch them. This one. Yeah. Just be careful when you build next to it. You see how they highlight yellow? So those are going to break if I build. You don't want to break the ones that... before you loot. See this one? Yeah, see? So, and once you've got, once you've, you know, looted them, you smash the crap out of everything. Yep. So yeah, that's about it. It's not very interesting, I know. It's just something that we all have to do from time to time when we run low on stuff. Alright. So if you guys like this content and you want to support the channel, please use code Diggy in the item shop. I really appreciate it. And thank you to everyone who has used it. And if you haven't already, please join the Discord. I'll put a link in the description and also pin it in the top comment. All right, I will see you guys in the next video or on Discord. All right, peace.